Hello and welcome to another unboxing video with Neo Rambler. This time we have something quite nice, Yu-Gi-Oh related of course, hence the title of the video, and it is some Yu-Gi-Oh Retro Pack 2s. Yay! Again, sorry for the glare of the light from the plastic packaging, but yeah, we've got some Retro Pack 2s to open up, which is quite nice. Now, it's not the the special edition boxes that came, I believe, with a Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon for a secret rare. No, this is the slightly different one. Still three packs, but comes with a Green Baboon Defender of the Forest as a secret rare. Not quite as cool as Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon, but still nice anyway, because these are getting very hard to get hold of and they're expensive. I might get some more in the future, but as of now I'm trying to save some money for other things, so we're going to open up these packs just to see what we get, and maybe if we're lucky we might get the elusive and expensive Blue Eyes Shining Dragon secret rare. Yeah, fat chance. Probably get a load of rares, maybe a holo. I highly doubt it. But either way, it doesn't matter, because it's cool to get nostalgic cards no matter what. I forget which sets these this retro pack covers. But either way, it's going to be cool to open up regardless, so I'm looking forward to it. Now, we've got three of these to open up, so we've got three packs per pack, or per box even, or per whatever blister packaging it is. I've got three of these, so there's going to be nine packs to open up, and we'll see what we can get. Yeah, might get it, might get the cool stuff. Either way, it's just going to be nice to see cards as a blast from the past. So, I'm going to open up the packs that I've got, get them ready, and then we'll open them up. So, be right back. Actually, just before I open up the final one, because these packages tear very easily, I just thought I'd show you the back of the pack, although you're probably not going to be able to see it very well, again, because I have a poor camera and poor lighting, but still, it's got some print on the back of Blue Eyes Shining Dragon, Harpy's Pet Dragon, Dragon Master Knight, really cool card, and they've highlighted the two sort of powerful equipped spell cards of the time, Mage Power and United We Stand. Isn't that nice? So I'll just read the blurb on the back. A pet dragon of your own. Retro Pack 2 reprints many cards that are very old and can be difficult to collect. You don't say. One of the oldest is Harpy's Pet Dragon, which was printed for the first and only, although nowadays obviously not, but back when this pack was new, time, all the way back in 2002. If you wanted a Harpy's Pet Dragon for your collection, this is your best chance to get one. Except now that we've got eBay, we can just buy them separately, but whatevers. You can also find other great reprints in Retro Pack 2, including Blue Eye Shining Dragon and Dragon Master Knight. Isn't that sweet? Awesome attack boosts. Retro Pack 2 contains two of the most powerful equipped cards ever created, United We Stand and Mage Power. Hooray. United We Stand gives the equipped monster plus 800 attack for every monster you control, including that monster, and Mage Power gives the equipped monster plus 500 attack for every spell or trap card you control, including itself. I know, I can read the blurbs on the card, but still. Since you can only summon once per turn, United We Stand can take some time to build up points, but if you set a bunch of spell or trap cards, Mage Power can easily give your monster a plus 2,000... or even a plus 2,500 boost right away. I can do maths, and if you can't, this box can for you. I love stuff like that. So yeah, that's just the back of the box. Right, time to continue unpacking them, and then we'll get these packs opened. And we've got our packs ready. But before we do, let's just have a quick look at this secret rare card. Oops. Ah, oh no. Tilted the camera. I've got it on a box, you see. That's why I'm professional. Not. Anyway, right, back to track. So we've got Green Baboon Defender of the Forest. There he is, the big ugly mug. 2600 attack, 1800 defense, level 7. And his effect is, when a beast type monster you control is destroyed and sent to the graveyard, you can pay 1000 life points to special summon this card from your hand or graveyard. Might still be pretty good for today. I don't know. But they've changed the rules up. Now we've got Link summoning and all that other bollocks. So yeah, maybe not so much. But still, it's a nice secret rare. For what it is. But we don't care about that, we care about the packs. So hopefully I don't knock the camera over. Let's see what we get. I really do like this pack design. I think it's really neat. Got Yamayugi on the front there, or the Pharaoh holding up a card, getting ready to play his children's card game to save the world. And I forget what that monster's called in the back left. It's Beast of Gilfer, I think, or something like that. And then we got Gaia. Gaia the Fierce Knight. I was thinking Dragon Knight then, but still. And yeah, and on the back you've got all this MacGuffin, 9 cards in every pack, not intended for individual sale. Oh no, well luckily I'm opening them so I won't be struck down for that. In ancient Egypt, there existed a force so powerful, blah, blah, blah. We know all that sort of stuff. So, yeah, it's really hard to get secret rares out of the set. I think there's, like, well over 200 or 300 cards in the set, or at least between 200 and 300 cards in the set. So, chances are of us getting any holos and stuff are very, very low. But let's find out, shall we? We've got 9 to open. So, let's begin and find out. I'm excited. I'm going to buy some more of these, but slowly over time. So, there might be another video later on in the future where we open up some more. But I got impatient. And now I can't open up the pack because it's so old and it's stuck. Hang on. I have to do it off screen. Hey, there we go. Oh, it's split. Oh, I don't want to rip the packs, you see, but never mind. Ah, that's not too bad. Okay. Ugh, there we go. First pack. Let's see what we've got. Again, hopefully you can see it as well as it can. We've got Gravekeeper Spy, Lightning Blade, Spirit Message N, Torrential Tribute, and a Revival Jam for our rare. Ah, that was a cool card in the anime series. I think Yamayugi uses it against Strings, one of Marikishtar's, what do they call them? I forget now. But, you know, the Rare Hunters, that was it. So, yeah, pretty cool. But a Torrential Tribute in common. That's pretty neat. I like it. We've got Bazoo the Soul Eater. Good super rare back in the day. We used that a lot. Reckless Greed. Draw 2 cards and skip your next two draw phases. I think... I don't know if that's banned or limited still. I really don't know. I can't remember. Card of Safe Return. That's pretty awesome. And Asura Priest. A spirit monster that was never really that good anyway. Well, they were. They were all right until they got banned. Like Yatagarasu and all that. But anyway, right. I'm going to open up these packs, like I said, off screen because they're a bit old and tight. Ah, this one wasn't too bad. Oh, no. It's split. No. Bloody hell. Never mind, doesn't matter. As I said, I like to keep the old wrappings, you see, because I'm weird like that. I have no life. Right, second pack then. Let's see what we get. We've got Gilosaurus. Not a bad card, actually, Gilosaurus, if you've got a dinosaur deck. Creature Swap. I had one of those, or pulled one of those as an ultra rare back in the day. Still pretty good, actually. Not a bad card. Light Force Sword. Not really. It could still be useful for today, I guess. Yatagarasu, there you go. That was the secret rare spirit monster. I forget which pack it was in. Was it Dark Crisis? No, Dark Crisis was Archfiend. It might have been Legacy of Darkness, I think. Either way, really good card. And yeah, banned because it can easily be exploited. Ooh, we got a super rare Buster Blader. Well, we got a holo. So do you know what? I'm happy with that. So yeah, good old Buster Blader. Never pulled one in the day, but I think I traded for one. And I used it from time to time, but... yeah, it's just a cool retro card to have a look at. That's sweet. Dust Tornado, awesome. Spirit Message, I. Gravekeeper's Chief. Don't think I ever saw this card. I know it was around back in my day. Well, we had the Gravekeepers, but I don't think I ever saw this one that well. You can only control one Gravekeeper's Chief card in your graveyard. Wait, you can only control one graveyard... I can't read because I'm tired. You can only control one Gravekeeper's Chief. Cards in your graveyard are unaffected by Necrovalley. When this card is tribute summoned, you can special summon one Gravekeeper's monsters from your graveyard. Huh. I know the Gravekeeper's deck style thing back in the day was actually pretty good, but there you go. Ooh, and a common Goblin Attack Force. Again, I traded for one of these when it was ultra rare. I can't remember which pack it was from originally, but still. I liked Goblin Attack Force. Not the best card in the world, but certainly back then. 2300 attack, if you summoned it quite early on. It was a good sort of defense mechanism. You didn't have to attack with it, but... not many four-star, well, hardly any four-star monsters even today could get past it, but I think nowadays it's a bit easier. But back then, it was pretty cool. Right, okay, pack number 3. Let's see what we got. We've got Call of the Haunted, good times. Dark Room of Nightmare, which I'd never really understood. Each time your opponent takes damage from a card effect, except Dark Room of Nightmare, inflict 300 damage to your opponent. So I guess if you had like a burn deck or a deck where you just burn their life points quick, this could be helpful, but... I don't know, it was a super rare back in the day, never really used it. Spirit Message L, Spear Dragon, good card back then. And, ooh, a secret rare! Not the one I wanted, but I'll take it. It's an Archfiend of Gilfer. There you go, it wasn't the Beast of Gilfer, it was the Archfiend of Gilfer. Well, there you go, a secret rare. Quite hard to get from these packs, so I'll take it. Wish it was Blue Eyes Shining Dragon, but you know what? Doesn't matter. It's the privilege of having a secret rare from a retro pack. When this card is sent to the graveyard, you can equip it to a monster on the field, and that equipped monster loses 500 attack. Not really the best effect in the world, but I don't know. Maybe back in the day it was alright. Noble Band of Crossout, awesome. Mask of Restrict Common, nice. I had an ultra rare version again. I think I traded for it. I don't know if I ever pulled it, but I used it in my Exodia deck. Still quite useful today. Opticlops and Parasite. Again, I think I traded for this one. Good super rare back in the day. I really liked it. Apparently the Japanese image for this, or the Japanese version of this card, the image was a lot more disturbing, but they censored it or toned it down for the English audiences. Because, you know, we're pretty pathetic as a people. I can say that because I'm English, you see. Right, anyway. Not that I've got anything against English people, though, just for clarity's sake. Although I'm sure I'll get loads of people going, "Oh, you hate the English." No, I am English. I can say it. It's fine. Right, anyway, pack number four. Can't believe it. One secret rare and a super rare. That's pretty good, actually, for these packs. I'm happy with that. Let's see if we can continue that trend. So we've got Gilosaurus, creature swap again. Lightfall Sword. I sense a repeating pattern here. Yep, so what did we get for this one? Buster Blader, was it? Oh, no. Limiter removal. Nope. Is that a super rare? Nope, is that a super rare? I think it... Is that the super rare? Yeah, it is. Is that a super rare? It doesn't look like it. Wow, the holo on that is so... It's a super rare, limited removal. Good card, though. And it's quite good, actually, for a Toon deck. I might try and put that in my Toon deck, actually, so I didn't have one spare. But, yeah, the holo on it is really poor, so it looks like a common. But it is holographic, though. How about that? But good card, though. Like that. Another Mask of Restrict. Spirit Message Eye. Ooh, Barrel Behind the Door. Activate only when a card's effect that would inflict damage to your... It's activated. Your opponent takes the damage instead. That could be pretty good. And Tornado Wall. Marvellous. Cool. So we've got two super rares, one secret rare. That's pretty good. Now, how many packs we got left? I think we've got four. Oh, wait, was it five? Five left, including this one? Let's see what else we can get. Ooh, not done too badly, actually, thinking about it. If we got a Blue-Eyed Shining Dragon there, I'd be, like, stoked. I would have to, like, pause the video and go outside and cry in ecstasy and say, "My life is sad, but I got a Shining Dragon." But that isn't going to happen. But it doesn't matter. We got a secret rare and two supers anyway, so I'm pleased. So, right, pack number five. We've got Gravekeeper's Assailant, Thousand Eyes Idol. Love this card. Only because, you know, it's completely and utterly crap on its own, but combine it with Relinquished, Thousand Eyes Restrict. Awesome. Spirit Message L, good times, Curse of the Mass Beast, and we got another Buster Blader. Damn it, I hate it when you get repeat holos like this. Like, look, you're a rare pack set with rare holos, and I get two of the same bloody thing. God damn it. But still, three super rares and a secret. Not going to complain. Except when I just did. But still. Dark Spirit of the Silence. Spirit Message I. Opticlops. And a Sura Priest again. I hate it when you get repeats. But still, cool. Doing really well, actually, in terms of ratios. Let's see if we can continue. I highly doubt it, but, you know... Not a bad... Well, no, it's good. It's good. I should not be shooting it down. It's good. Right, pack six. What are we going to get? We've got a Book of Moon. Flip one face-up monster on the field and face-down defense position. It's a quick play spell card. Quite good, though, actually. Don't know if that's limited or banned. I think it's limited. Not sure. Kaiku the Ghost Destroyer. Loved this card back in the day as a beat stick because every time it inflicted battle damage, you could banish two monster cards from your opponent's graveyard. And your opponent couldn't remove from play cards from either player's graveyard. That's useful as well. I like that. I didn't know it had that effect. Oh, that's cool. Common Premature Burial. It was always banned for ages. Never pulled an ultra rare one. Got a common one from a starter deck, I think. Still cool. Call of the Haunted. And a Kaiser Seahorse, which is pretty good, actually, for Blue Eyes deck if you needed to summon it quickly, because this counts as two tributes for a light monster. Yeah. Book of Taiyu, flip one face down monster on the field into face up attack mode, except it's not a quick play spell card, which is interesting. Oh, well. Another Barrel Behind the Door, another Gravekeeper's Chief, and another Parasite. I hate it when these packs repeat. This set is huge, I promise you. I'm not lying. I probably am, actually, but whatever. It doesn't matter. No, I'm not lying. No, it's a big set. And we've got yet more repeats, so here we go. We've got Gravekeeper's Spy once again, another Lightforce Sword, another Curse of Mass Beast. Ooh, Mad Sword Beast, though. That's new. During battle between this attacking card and the defense position monster, whose defense is lower than the attack of this card, inflict the difference of battle damage to your opponent. And we've got an Obnoxious Celtic Guardian. This card cannot be destroyed by battle with a monster that has 1900 or more attack. Yeah, not bad. That's all right. I like the artwork on that one, though. Pretty awesome. Another Parasite. Ooh, Emergency Provisions. Didn't have one of these. Got one now. That's good. That's a good card still. No Mana Crossout. And, oh, Common Gemini Elf. Nice. I think I got quite a few of these, though, knocking around. But still, it's nice to pull. I remember that was a secret rare, I think, in Magician's Force. I think it was. Was it Magician's Force, or was it... No, it wasn't. It wasn't Magician's Force. What was it? It was... Was it Legacy of Darkness, I think? Oh, yeah, I think it was Legacy of Darkness that was a secret rare. I think that was like the first sort of main 4-level star monster 1900 attack beatstick thing. It was very desirable back then. Love to get a secret rare version of that card. But oh well. Alright, never mind. Oh, two more packs left to go. Let's see what we get. A new card, Skull Invitation. Each time a card is sent to the graveyard, inflict 300 points of damage to its owner for each card sent. Gravekeeper's Assailant. Pretty nice. Insect Imitation. That's pretty good. Yeah, I've got to remember that. Another Mad Sword Beast. And an Alpha the Magnet Warrior. Oh, I remember this. This was a promo in... Oh, which game was it? Was it Duelist Kingdom? No, Duelist of the Roses, I think. That was the game. That's pretty awesome. I like that. Azura Priest. Melchid, or Melchid, the Four-Faced Beast. Spirit Message A. And another Gemini Elf. Coolio. Last pack, then. All right, then. Let's have a look-see. Can't believe, though. Four holos. Awesome. Just wish you didn't have two of the same bloody holo. Oh, well. Never mind. Right. We have... Ooh, Guardian Sphinx. I liked this card. This was an ultra rare, I think, in Dark Crisis. I could be wrong about that one. Once per turn, you can flip this card into face-down defense position. When this card is flip summoned, return all monsters your opponent controls to their owner's hand. That was really good. I liked that card. It was really annoying. My mate had it years ago when we used to play in the old days, and he used to use it against me all the time, and I bloody hated it. It was annoying. Gilosaurus. Cool. Creature Swap. Nightforce Sword. And Gearfrid the Iron Knight. Ah, well. At least we got some holos. And do you know what? As a rare, that's a good one to end on. Gearfrid the Iron Knight. When an equipped card is equipped with this card, destroy the equipped card. And then it created that Butterfly Dagger Elmer chain effect. That was quite funny. And then it got banned. Opticlops. Ooh, Magic Drain. Negate the activation of opponent's spell card and destroy it. Your opponent then can discard one spell card to negate this effect. I like Magic Drain, actually. That was a pretty good trap card by then. Another Reckless Greed and an Appropriate. Activate when your opponent draws a card, except during their draw phase. Draw two cards. Pretty neat. And there you go. So, those are 9 packs, then, of Retro Pack 2. And I have to say, 1 Secret Rare, 3 Supers. Not bad at all, considering. Except the 2 Buster Bladers. God damn it. But still, pretty good. So, hope you enjoyed that and killed a bit of time. And yeah, I'm going to keep buying some of these, but obviously I'm going to just put the brakes on for a bit so I'm trying to save some money. There's still some stock from a guy on eBay, so I'll probably get another 3 of them and then do another video on these and then see what we get. Then we'll take it from there. But until then, take it easy, have a good one. Hope you're well, hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in another video. Ooh, retro, retro. Not in 3D, but it's still nauseating anyway. I'm really immature. Anyway, see you in the next one.